I usually go in my community like every year and listen. More like just have one-to-ones, have house groups in churches, in the mosque, in other institutions. Just listen, what are the key issues that are actually affecting our communities so that I'll know what to work on. If it's unemployment, I'll actually make an effort to make sure that I get young people into jobs. So end of last year, something really different happened because I work for a youth center called Active Horizons. And I realized that every Monday when we make hot food for young people to eat before they go home, some Mondays they come in and they're so desperate to eat. They come in the kitchen, have you done finished cooking? Have you finished cooking? You know? But some Mondays, you call them 20 times, they don't even come to eat. So then I started to ask them, why is it some Mondays you come here so hungry, some Mondays you're not hungry? And they said, because there's a £1 chicken and chip shop right on the corner. It's a £1 pizza right next to the youth center. So then I did ask them, so how many times in a week do you actually eat this £1 chicken and chips? And they said 6 times in a week, except for Sunday when they go to church. So to me, that was quite interesting, just to realize how much it's so easy to say even that £1 you find, the first thing you think is to go and eat, you know, £1 chicken and chips. So I did ask them, okay, so why the £1 chicken and chips? Why can't you go home and make a little sandwich or something like that? And they said, well, because I can't cook, simple as. And from that's when I had the idea of how about I actually go into my community and teach young people how to cook, how to make healthy meals in the most funniest way I can find. Obviously, it's not as fun to facilitate a cooking session, but I did try my best. But because obviously I only had like 12 sessions to facilitate, I thought, how about I also work with local catering owners, like people that own their own catering businesses or people that own their restaurants, to actually come into the youth center and facilitate some of the sessions. So from that, I got funding from Live Unlimited that made it possible for me to go into my community and teach young people how to cook. But obviously, funding does run out, obviously. Thinking forward, so what can I do to generate income? What can I do for me to move forward? Fair enough, these 2 months have gone so well. I've taught more than 30 young people how to cook. But some of them, maybe they only had the privilege to come for one session, but that wasn't enough for them. What about those that want to continue? What about for that project? If I want to continue, what can I do to generate income? So then that's when I thought, okay, how about I start my own social enterprise? That's when I started Divine Enterprise, which goes into the community and cater for events. And the biggest challenge for me with that was obviously having a team that can commit to actually come on board and be able to cater for events. Sometimes we don't make as much because it's still quite a very small business. But because I come from a big family, I decided to make my whole family to do food and hygiene course so that we can all go and cater for the events. But also, in terms of the future, I'm hoping someday to open up my own restaurant. What I find unique and different about the opportunity that I was given by Life Unlimited, I never had the dream to actually start my own catering company. I never had the courage and the confidence to actually do something that I'm able to give back to the community, or do something that I can actually employ someone. Employment is a big issue in our community. But because of the project that they funded me, the kitchen delight of teaching young people how to cook, a lot of people approached me and said, you know what, your food is quite nice. How about you cater for our events? So some people have their dreams come true by dreaming about them. You dream about them 5 years, 10 years, and then when money comes, it comes true. Some people, maybe it's a skill that you have, and then it becomes into a dream. But for me, my dream came true because of the opportunity that I was given. And with that, I just want to thank Life Unlimited for such an opportunity. Thank you.